பயணி. தாவரமில்லை தனக்கொரு வீடில்லை தேவா.
சோ யூ ஜஸ்ட் செட் தட் வி ஹியூமன் ஷுட் யூஸ் அவர் ஆர்கன்ஸ் வைஸ்லி சோ தட் தே லாஸ்ட் அஸ் ஃபார் அ லைஃப் டைம். But on the other hand, we are seeing that today's youth are more inclined towards drinking, weed and smoking. So how do you think should we raise the consciousness towards them, or how can an individual like me can help at least one or two to realize that these things are not good for health?
One or two, make up your mind, huh?
Two, sir.
So, when somebody has tasted some pleasantness, either to drug or drink or sexuality, whatever, they tasted some pleasantness. If there was no pleasantness, they wouldn't have gone that way. But the pleasantness may suck them into destroying their body, that's another matter. But the pleasantness is such that even in spite of the threat, cigarette smoking is going, you know, injurious to you and you show some cancerous mouth, all this. But still people are smoking because there is a pleasantness attached to it, whatever the consequence may be. If you want to get people out of the pleasantness, if you try this forcefully, well, it's not worked. What's the point doing something forcefully? Or first of all, what's the point doing something that doesn't work? You must offer them a pleasantness which is beyond that. You're a bit too far away, but Riya, look at my eyes and see, don't I look stoned? No, just look at me properly. I'm always stoned. I'm always stoned, never touched a substance. I'm asking you, is it true that this body is the most sophisticated and complex chemical factory on the planet? If you were a good CEO, would you manufacture what you want? When somebody gives you such a complex machinery, would you not manufacture what you want? Right now, you are busy manufacturing unpleasantness. You may call it stress, you may call it anxiety. Essentially, you are chemically screwed up. Yes or no? Because you don't know how to manage this. If you manage this well, you will produce that kind of pleasantness within you, you wouldn't want to touch anything else because this life is just being alive is such a fantastic thing. But unfortunately, did we teach our youth any other way to know pleasantness? We did not teach, so they are puss, puss, puss. It's time. This is what consciousness means. That if you become conscious how this functions, naturally you will create highest level of pleasantness for yourself, isn't it? If you could sit here and be absolutely blissed out, would you smoke? I'm asking you, would you? You wouldn't smoke, drink or pop anything because there is more chemistry here than you can get in any of those things. Is there or no? There is more complexity of chemistry here or no? Question is only, have you explored this possibility? That's the only thing. Unfortunately, we have taken to Western ways, whether it comes to health or pleasure, both ways we pop. We pop something to be healthy chemicals, to be peaceful chemicals, to be joyful chemicals, to any experience chemicals, even to grow food chemicals, to filter water, purify water chemicals. Something that kills all the insects and worms and germs and whatever, you think it's not killing you in some way? Maybe slowly the dose is not enough, that's all. Hello? The dosage is not enough. For the small creature, small dose, big creature, big dose, isn't it? So for everything, chemicals. So this is something, this is a responsibility that's sitting on our heads right now, disease. The way the world is going right now, I estimate, unless we do something drastic in the next 10-15 years' time, I estimate in another 50 to 75 years' time, almost 90 to 95% of the humanity will be on chemicals for everything. To be healthy, to be peaceful, to be joyful, already consumption of this has gone up 10,000% in the last 25 years. Yes or no? Hello, has it not gone up 100 times? Because other things that people promised elsewhere are all collapsing. People told you it doesn't matter, you're miserable, when you go to heaven everything will be wonderful. But slowly in your mind, the hope of heaven is collapsing. Maybe you still don't dare to utter it, but it's collapsing, isn't it? Yes or no? So you want to do everything here, but nobody taught you how to do it in such a way you can have the highest level of pleasure and still it'll enhance your life. This needs a little application. Unfortunately, we have not explored. If you do not raise human consciousness to a point where a whole lot of human beings know how to do things within themselves, if this does not come in the society, 90 to 95% of the population in 50 years or plus will be on chemicals. Now, this is not a moral issue for me. If 95% of the humanity goes on chemicals, the next generation that we produce will be a generation which is much less than ourselves. See, the purpose of next generation is somehow, at least one notch, they must be better than us. If we produce a generation which is worse than us, this is a crime against humanity. We have taken humanity backwards. And once you do that, afterwards we don't know what the next one will do. See, this is not some prediction by looking at astrological stuff, looking at the human mind. When all these machines come, when this chemical usage goes out of control, you should not be surprised in another 60 to 75 years' time if a huge percentage of population is committing suicide. You should not be surprised at all, because a human being doesn't need just pleasure, he needs a purpose. But one thing that happens to you with chemical usage is, you lose a sense of purpose, your pleasure, but no purpose. So there are various kinds of pleasures. There are intellectual pleasures, there are physical pleasures, there are other dimensions of pleasures, there are emotional pleasures, the pleasure of activity. Climbing a mountain can be a great pleasure, though there is a lot of pain in the body. Yes or no? So if we do not explore other dimensions, everybody will fall back on chemicals. When this happens, you will see the suicide rate in the world will increase enormously. I must tell you this, I grew up in early 70s and whatever. At least 12, 13, if I count little far away friends also, nearly 14 people. All my age, we were all like, you know, on motorcycles and trekking and doing crazy things in the mountains, all kinds. But a whole lot of them, at least 60% of them at that time went on drugs and alcohol. A few of us stayed out of it, but rest went on it heavily. We were all together, but they were all half the day, they were sozzled out. You have to find a time to wake them up. But we were together. At least 14 of them died before they reached 35. Either drugged out or they killed themselves with excessive drinking, or they died on the motorcycles, riding crazy on intoxicated conditions. 14 of my friends died before they reached 35. That number is going to increase phenomenally if we go in this direction. This is a backward step in life. It is not a question of morality. It is a fundamental thing about life itself. So whether it's in agriculture or purification of water or daily consumption of prescription medication, this is rising like crazy, this is not good. And these kind of, recreational drugs. If the chemical consumption increases, humanity will take a backward step. We should not let that happen. For this, the only and only solution is, we must create a conscious human being. Raising human consciousness is the most important thing. For this, the important thing is to move everybody from belief systems to responsibility, because we have managed humanity with carrot and stick. See, if you do all this thing, if you drink alcohol here, we'll put you in hell and torture you forever. So that man stayed away from drink, and we told you, don't worry, in heaven, rivers flow with wine. We have managed humanity like this for a long time. See, all of you are laughing, but the previous generations genuinely believed it, isn't it? Yes or no? So now heavens have collapsed in people's minds. They are trying to do their own little heaven here. You cannot stop them unless you provide a credible alternative.
வேளிக்குள் வேறும் பாழாய் நின்றதை இட்டமாய் பார்ப்பாயடி கூதம்பாய் இட்டமாய் பார்ப்பாயடி தாவரமில்லை.